The Public Accounts Committee of Parliament has today interfaced with officials of the Uganda Cancer Institute over queries raised by the Auditor General's report for the financial year that ended June 2022. The committee queried officials for diverting 269 million shillings from activities they were budgeted for without authority, which is contrary to the Public Finance Management Act.
From a sample of transactions reviewed, I noted that funds to the tune of 269,511,315 were irregularly diverted from the activities on which they were budgeted and spent on other activities without seeking and obtaining the necessary approvals. So now for us, we're asking you, why did you spend without the necessary approvals and authority?
I think there was a condition on the lab. That's why we mischarged that money we are talking about.
The Auditor General attributed it to budget indiscipline, poor budgeting practices, and failure to adhere to financial management controls. Uganda Cancer Institute explained that there were emergencies to cater for personal protective equipment, but this did not convince the committee, as it was in absence of evidence of an approval from the secretary to the treasury.
Actually, a good part of this diversion was in emergency situation.
Oh,
yes. The emergency situation is this. We were never provided for the COVID situation in as far as the personal protective gears were concerned.
Look at the law. The law is flexible, it is permissive when you want to divert resources. Actually, the issue here is irregular. The word is irregular diversion. It's not that funds did not do, all funds were stolen. They could have actually done the activities you're explaining. But the issue is that the process was not in accordance with the law.
The committee also interrogated officials on unaccounted for funds amounting to 292 million shillings, which were paid to different suppliers without supporting documents.
They did not have a voucher then during the audit. Management later, exit, then even that voucher, if it is given now, it is thought of to be a fictitious voucher. Why would it fail to get to the other auditors and it comes now?
In that case, since the vouchers were not received then, by any good chance, as among the documents you came with.
Although they insisted that the missing supporting documents were later discovered and submitted to auditors, the Auditor General officials refuted claims, saying accountability is still missing.
The matter that was raised during the audit, it was raised in the management later, raised in the exit meeting, and was carried on up to this point. All those were avenues for you to explain yourself. So do you want to tell us that, for example, you gave them to them yesterday? When do you give them to them and they are not on file?
The committee then gave Uganda Cancer Institute officials one day to produce payment vouchers partaking payments of the unaccounted funds in question.
We've just requested them to avail us proof of payments of the 292 million shillings that was paid to suppliers, and of course we have given them up to close of this week, because we are going to communicate to visit the hospital as we look at the project that is there.
Uganda Cancer Institute also came under fire for underpayment of pension to a tune of 31 million to 18 pensioners, and non-payment of gratuity amounting to 24 million shillings to a one staff member called Grace Margaret Akulo, who retired in September 2020.
Not be paying someone's pension and you do not have their details, that would not be the same details used to pay their gratuity. So what exactly happened?
Transferred to the institute 3 years before she died. And she was transferred from Ministry of Public Service. And when she worked with us and the audit was done, that is when we actually realized that our documents are not complete, and the process of regularizing that started, and that went to the time when actually she was retiring. But unfortunately, that was also the time she died. She succumbed to COVID.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.